Well, I'm going to assume that you've downloaded the G-code generator, the new version, version 6, and if you haven't, then you should probably go ahead and do that. Once you do, you're going to want to create a folder to put it in. For now, I've got mine just on the desktop here, and it's right here. So I'm going to open that up, and here's the zip file that you'll be downloading from the website. That's version 6A1. It's a compressed file, so you'll just right click on it and select extract all and do that. Okay, once you've done that, it creates a new folder, and that's where the actual G-code generator is. This is the zip file. I'm going to close that. We don't need that anymore. So anyway, here's the G-code generator. There's a file in here called new text. This file has to be in the same folder as the G-code generator itself. Without that, the scripts that copy and create new files will not work. So that's why I included it in the zip file. There's also a README text file here, and this just tells you to place it wherever you want it, and that you have to have the new text file in there. Then it also mentions you must enable macros right here to copy, for the buttons to copy the G-code. You do not have to enable macros to run this spreadsheet. If you do not run macros, then you have to manually copy and paste the G-code into an empty text file to create the G-code files. With the macros enabled, it just simplifies that task for you. So let's dive right in here and we'll open up the G-code generator. This is where it opens up to start with. It'll be on the cover page that has just some generic directions that talk about bit sizes and whatnot. Most of you have already seen this. If you haven't, I would encourage you to read it. If you have the earlier versions, like version 5, and you've read through this, then you can skip through that. This is a new feature. At the top of each page is a navigation menu. Sometimes this menu will be over here on the top left corner, which is where it is on most pages. On this page, it's in the middle. When you click on that, it takes you to the navigation menu. And this is a list of all the pages that are included in the spreadsheet. The Mach 3 script that's right here is not enabled at this time. I'm currently working with Alan Massey from the Inventables Forum. He has a Mach 3 system, and he has already written the script to use this touch plate with Mach 3. We made a few tweaks to it to make it even better, and I'm just waiting for him to finish testing to make sure that it's working perfectly before we actually activate it. So if you're a Mach 3 user and you're looking at this, it's coming, guys. Just bear with me. I want to make sure that it's right before we put it out there for you. But I expect that within the week, this will be taken care of. So before the month of May is over, you should have a good working Mach 3 script. Okay, for all the Gerbil guys, such as me, the navigation menu's got the cover page, which we just looked at. There's a settings page right here, and this is the first place you're going to go once you get this spreadsheet up and running. So let's go ahead and go there. This is where you're going to set your measurements for your touch plate. You can set them in inches or in millimeters just by changing this button right here. So this would be in millimeters, so all these measurements would be in millimeters here and not inches, or we'll stay in inches. Well, I'm an inch guy, so we'll go in inches here. So on my touch plate, my z-axis is 0.8090. My x-axis is 1.965, and my y-axis is 2.5. Your measurements will likely be different. They're the same touch plates, but we're getting down into the thousandths of an inch to be accurate, so yours will be a little bit different. And one thing to remember, you don't have to be dead spot on accurate with this. What you need to be is consistent, and that's one of the beauties of this system, is that your zero position will always be the same. Now, if it's off very much, if you're using an old wooden ruler to measure your touch plate, then you're going to want to go to the fine-tuning page. And there's another video on that out that I put on the website that explains in detail how to do that. But you can get this thing in very, very close. So anyway, we've got our measurements in. And so we'll go back to the navigation menu. And let's just go to the straight to the inch mode page here. You'll notice that the Z-axis, the X-axis, and the Y-axis are all grayed out. You won't change these values here. If you need to make an adjustment to these, it'll all be done on the settings page where we were just at. The only thing you're going to put in on this page is the feed rate and your bit diameters. Feed rates can be anywhere from 1 to 5. I wouldn't recommend going above 5 because your bit moves too quickly and can damage your bit or actually push the touch plate away before it can zero out your machine. So I leave mine set at 2. It's not the fastest in the world, but it doesn't take very long to do. And once you've done it, you don't have to mess with it again unless you change bits. On your bit diameter, these will always be in decimal format. However, you don't have to convert that yourself. If you know you have a 1/8 inch bit, you can just put in 1/8 and it converts it for you. If you had a 5/8 inch bit, just put in 5/8 in a fraction format, and again it automatically converts for you. But we'll stick with the 1/8 inch bit. Anytime you change these values, this code right here changes. You don't necessarily see it happening, but it does happen. It happens pretty quick. So anyway, once you have your G code, so now we know we have a G code right here for a 1/8 inch bit that's moving at 2 inches per minute. If you have a macros enabled, then you're going to click on Select and Copy G code. Right here, you can see where it's selected all the code. It's got the little marching ants driving around it. Then you're just going to click on Create a New File. It opens up that new text file that I showed you. Right click, paste, file, save as, and then just give it a name. And so I'll just put down 1_8 for a 1/8 inch bit and save it. Then I can close this file, and now we have a G-code file that will zero any 1/8 inch bit that you have, whether it's a V-bit, a ball nose, an end mill, or maybe it's even a 1/32 inch ball nose that's on a 1/8 inch shank. It'll zero that as well, because when you zero, you're always going to zero to the largest diameter of the bit. If it's the shank, then you zero to the shank. If you have a smaller shank and a big cutter, like say you got a 1/4 inch shank and a 1 inch cutter for your wasteboard, then you would zero to the 1 inch cutter portion of it. So you would have a new file, in which case you'd go right here and you'd put in a 1 inch. Then you would save the file. You just select copy, create new file, and save again. So let's go back to the main navigation menu. In millimeter mode, even though we put our measurements in the settings page in inches, you can see that it's all in millimeters over here. Okay, now this warning up here just tells you that you put everything in settings page in inches, but it gets converted automatically, so you don't have to worry about that. Again, right here we're doing a 3.175 millimeter bit, which would be an 1/8 inch bit, and you just select and copy, create new G-code, and move right on down the line just like you normally would. So let's go back to the navigation menu. I'll come back to this alternate XY location here in just a moment. This spreadsheet still has the same fine-tuning sheet as before. There's a video on that, so I won't go into that here. There's the stepper calibration. Again, this is the same as it was before. There's a video for that, so again, we'll skip that for now. And revision history, this just shows all the changes as this program has grown. So here we go, alternate XY0 location. There's been a lot of people that have asked me, do I have to always zero to the bottom left corner or the front left corner? And the answer has always been yes, not anymore. Now you can set your X and Y zero points at any location that you choose. Let's just assume that you have a 10-inch square piece of material and you want to put your XY zero in the center. So if it's 10 inches square, then we automatically know that 5 inches up and 5 inches over would be the middle. So that's what I've got right here. Our x-axis offset is 5 inches, and our y-axis offset is 5 inches, and we're using a 1/8 inch bit. And we're in the inch mode. If you wanted to change to millimeter mode so that these numbers were in millimeters, you can either click right here and just switch over to millimeters. Now, when you switch, you have to change these to millimeters. Okay, so don't forget that. Whatever the settings page is what this needs to be. But we'll just stick with inches. And we'll go back to our alternate XY0. And here we go. So anyway, this would set our XY offset right in the exact center of a 10-inch square piece of material. You can also set that to any of the corners. You can do, if this box right here was your work material, your V bit or your touch plate would normally be sitting right here on this corner. Okay, the offset would be measured from here. So in this case, 5 by 5, it would be 5 inches up, and then from this side, 5 inches over to get to the middle. If you wanted to your zero to be on this corner, then you would just measure straight up, so that your Y offset would be whatever measurement this would be. If you wanted this corner over here, then it would be your Y offset all the way to the back edge and your X offset all the way to the right side. And that would put your zero right up here. Same thing as over here. You wouldn't have a Y offset because it's still the same, but you would have an X offset. So anyway, that's how you get your zeros, your X and your Y zero, to be anywhere on this material that you want it to be. Again, you would just copy the G code, click the copy G code button. You'll see that it's already selected all the G code. You'll create a new file, right click and paste. There's our new file, and then choose save as. And in this case, I'll just put a 5-inch offset. Would be the name of our file, and I'll save it. And there we go. Now we have a 5-inch offset with a 1/8 inch bit, and we can put our XY location anywhere we like. So back to our navigation menu. This is much like the other version, except that it has the macros in it for copying and saving your new files. The Mach 3 script will be here soon. You Mach 3 guys, I hope you're excited about that. I am. And last thing you want to do is, before you leave this workbook, you actually want to go up here and save it, so that any changes you've made, which really would be on your settings page, these changes would be incorporated into your files. So next time you open it, these will always be here. If you don't save it, then you'll lose these. You'll have to put them in again. So anytime you change this, you want to be sure and save this spreadsheet. There's a lot of stuff going on behind the scenes that you do not see. There's a lot of calculations that are done. For that reason, I have each of these pages protected so that you cannot accidentally enter something in the wrong place. If you try to enter a number here, you're going to get a warning like this. It says that it's protected and read-only. The only place that you can enter data in this entire spreadsheet will be these blue boxes where you're just selecting inches and millimeters, or in a green box. Okay? So if you're on the Z-only page You can't change anything right here for your z-axis thickness. You get the error. But you can change your feed rate, which is the only thing you would want to change on this page anyway. So anyway, all the formulas are all actually all hidden behind all this stuff. You don't see them. There's quite a bit there. But it's all protected to make sure that it doesn't get messed up. And your spreadsheet will work all the time. So that's it for now. I hope you enjoy this new version. And as always, if you have questions or comments or feature requests, please don't hesitate to get a hold of me. My email address is on the cover page at the bottom, right down here. So you can always get a hold of me right here. And thank you for watching.